one with the best record in the West. The Clippers were one of the top teams against the West. They had a terrific in-conference record.
A touch over 2.5 minutes of basketball played here in the third quarter. Shot clock at 6. Throws it up high. Poked away.
Bounce pass.
Stolen by Harden. Oh, and a fast break for the Rockets. Harden's got the ball.
Harden doing it all. 13 points and 2 steals. Good contributions for him offensively with the assist and also making some nice steals.
Well, you're right, Clark. He's been equal parts creative and disruptive.
The Rockets, of course, at the forefront or vanguard as far as advanced analytics go. Some in the NBA have scoffed, but hey, they're doing something right.
The first one falls. And as you guys know, the Rockets at the forefront technology-wise, too. You see coaches with electronic tablets.
Well, they installed flat-screen monitors in the locker room, highlighting stats and videos for players. So, you know, they're trying to close the... loop and create that line of communication between the numbers crunchers and the players themselves.
Harden hits them both. With floor spacing, Steve, more important than ever in today's NBA, some have questioned the pairing of Griffin and Jordan in the Clipper front court.
Well, I think it's worked out just fine. I think they could add a stretch four behind those two guys and maybe mix him in during the rotations. But all in all, Griffin and Jordan have played awfully well together at both ends of the floor.
Now a timeout called by Houston.
And for the Clippers, their most potent offensive weapon is Chris Paul, coming off the pick and roll, attacking with great ball handling skills and vision. You want to create space for that, but defense more often than not will look to bring help from the front court, and that's when things really open up for Paul in terms of his options.
Now here's Beverly. He has 7. Kicks it out to Harden. In low to Howard. And stolen by Jordan. Griffin sets the screen for Paul. Off the pick. Misses off the right iron.
Easy look there, but, you know, he misses those once in a while.
And Beverly kicks to Harden. Pass to Mateus. Ariza outside. Shot is off. Jordan with some nice D. Los Angeles leading by 10. Jordan sets the pick for Paul. Kicks to Redick. Fires it up. The Rockets pull it in. Howard's got 3 rebounds now in this one. Harden right side. Now here's Paul, defended by Beverly. Here's the lob to the hoop.
Hey, get out of here. He was already on the way.
Houston takes possession.
Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. A terrible turnover.
Rockets trail by 10. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
Harden, no good.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
Had so much space there, and the defense really not showing him the respect. You can see his eyes get wide.
Beverly dishes to Mateus. They need this one. And it's Howard laying it in. Howard's got 6 points. Clippers leading by 10. Paul kicks to Redick. Jordan the screen. Over
Damn.
The corner, Barnes.
Oh,
six on the shot clock. That's a two from Paul. Rockets with the rebound. Howard's got four rebounds now tonight.
All right.
He just has not been able to get into that groove yet, guys. But as a whole, it hasn't affected them too much.
And he goes in for the dunk.
Major league big boy throwdown right there.
And he keeps a tight grip on that rim after the finish.
And maybe that'll give this team a little bit of their edge back. Chris Paul is really a basketball junkie. When he's not playing the game, he watches all the games. He has a wall of TVs in his home where he can follow multiple games at once. That is fanaticism. And he actually could be preparing for a job in the studio someday.
Jason Terry, he's checked in for the Rockets. Good on the second free throw.
You know, it's interesting. Chris Paul possessing great quickness, and yet his natural inclination is not to push the pace. He tends to prefer to operate in the half court, running the pick and roll.
Here's Beverly. It's hauled in by the Clippers.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
That's going to be over and back. Not watching for the line that time. You talk about Paul's preference to play in the half. Blake Griffin and DeAndre Jordan Clark tend to flourish in the open floor.
And to me, Kevin, it's really about finding that balance, the right balance. But a good sign for the Clippers has been Blake's development as a half-court offensive weapon. He's shooting it better facing the basket. He's shooting it better with his back to the basket. And he's making his free throws at a higher rate. So that lends itself to being a little more effective in the half-court.
Good observation. Redick with the three. Rebounded by Howard. Now here's Beverly. Not a lot of room. Passes it to Ariza. Now the feed to Terry. From 16 feet away, he cans it. And now just a 5-point Los Angeles lead. The Clippers have gone 4 of 9 from the floor so far in the third. Jordan sets the pick for Paul. At the elbow, Griffin. Back to Paul. He's looking for Jordan and finds him. From about 16. And the rebound goes to Howard. Howard's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Now Beverly. 7 points in the game. Back to Terry. Shoots the three. Clippers leading by 5. Griffin a screen on Ariza. Out to the right wing. Redick. They get it back. Terry against Paul. To the left side wing. Here's Redick. A second chance effort. And that one's good. Redick's got 12. Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
Beverly, the pass to Terry. Howard with it. He's got 8. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Howard's got 8 here in the quarter.
There's been a change in his game compared to what we saw in the first half. And he's scoring with a lot of confidence now.
Jordan sets the pick for Paul. And Redick kicks to Paul. Goes up to the stripe. Good! He's got 9. Rockets trail by 7. Here's Beverly. He has 7. He dishes it to Howard. He got right to the cup using that screen. Howard's got 12 in the game.
This is a fantastic performance in this half. He didn't play as well in the first, but you know, you just know with this guy, he's always ready to turn it around.
Griffin is green on Ariza. Six to shoot. Griffin goes in.
Oh, get it! Watch out now. And this sort of awesome dunk.
Coward, what are you talking about?
This team is in charge of this game right now.
Clark, there is a swagger out here on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either.
That's right. Those are phenomenal dunks to watch. So much fun.
And Chris Paul picks up the foul. That's his third foul of the game. A platoon swap here for the Clippers. Jones checked in for Houston. Now, here's Beverly. Ariza kicks to Jones. Shoots from the block. And he uses the glass on the layup. Jones has got six.
That's the kind of aggressive and assertive play they need as we get closer and closer to crunch time.
No question. Pounded into the painted area and continue to put pressure on that defense.
Houston making a switch here. Here's Farmar. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Crawford kicks to Farmar. Drains it from beyond the arc. And the Clippers lead by eight.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
I just love the mentality they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing anything. They're moving it side to side and working to get a good shot.
Here's Farmar. He feeds it to Crawford. Goes up on the high post. It's rebounded by Houston. Jones has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Beverly dishes to Terry. Banked in off the glass.
Really good example there of some fine interior passing before that basket.
5 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Here's Farmar. Defended by Beverly. Crawford, no luck.
You're not doing your team any good forcing a shot like that one.
No, I agree. He's got to know better than that.
1 second left. No good.
Foul.
And we reached the end of the third. Clippers lead by six.
Yeah, he tripped, though.
We'll be back shortly live from Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles.
You ran into me. I'm not supposed to stay in my position. Crazy. That's what you want.
Rockets trail by six. Fourth quarter on the court for the Rockets. Terrence Jones out there with Joey Dorsey. And there's Terry. Then it's Harden. And it's Papanikolo in at the three spot. Shot clock at six. Here's Dorsey. And Davis pulls it down. Davis has got his third rebound on the night. In the corner, it's Crawford. Now here's Terry. Harden outside. The pass to Papanikolo. Jones in the post. Davis is on it. It's good, and the Clipper lead is cut down now to just 4 points with the basket from Terrence Jones.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint. I guess the good news is they've taken away the outside shot.
Well, you know what? It doesn't matter how good their perimeter defense is if they're going to allow inside looks as easy as that.
Now here's Crawford. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires. And the Clippers lead by six.
Hold that.
Terry the pass to Dorsey.
See that. Oh, my.
Well, you allow
him to
rim like that.
Yeah.
That's your only option.
Well,